Let's go to our mothers and our wives. What can we say about our mothers and wives? They're like the moon, serene, beautiful to look at. So we don't want to say much. We don't want to say much because there's gloomy faces. Why are you guys all gloomy at the moment? Has a light bulb switched on in our heads? Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Tayyib. So our sisters are behind, so we won't say anything that makes them gloomy, inshallah. We'll format the discussion in a different way. Our mothers are entities of the home, as we've seen from the ayah in Surah Yusuf. And our wives, our mothers, have a great role to play in developing leaders. In fact, they are leaders themselves, and we'll come to that. Now, today's society, in many a circumstance and way, tries to take away the beauty from the name mother and take away the beauty from the term housewife. Today we say housewife, it sounds off. That we even have to engineer the name now and say, you know what, you know, it's not called housewives, it's called domestic engineer. It's a different title to this profession, right? Ala kulli hal, I have a different title to it as well, and that is the title of trim tabbers. Mothers and wives are trim tabbers. What's a trim tabber? This term was coined by Stephen Covey. I'm just evolving the usage of the term. A trim tabber is the small rudder on the ship that turns, which makes the bigger rudder on the ship turn, which makes the whole ship turn. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Imagine this. Who wants to be an accountant out there in the corporate world when you can be a trim tabber? Who wants to be out there in the corporate world doing any profession when you can be a trim tabber? Now, I'm not putting down the importance of educating ourselves as females and being able to carry society. This is important. But I'm saying don't do it at the expense of the greater and the more important. The travesty is when we do that at the expense of the greater. That's the travesty. We're not saying don't do it. We're saying yes, do it. But don't do it at the expense of that which is more important. It doesn't mean society said it's less important than it, that it's less important. The Sharia came to set down right from wrong. Right from wrong. It doesn't matter what society thinks. Yes, you're strange. As I told the brothers the other day, why not? We should be strange people. Islam began strange. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَطُوبَ لِلْ غُرَبَى, glad tidings to the strange people. You must be strange. A strange one is somebody who's doing something that's not the status quo, the norm of society. Now we're not saying that everything strange is good. But I'm saying when you follow the Sharia and that becomes strange, you should be happy. You should be happy. You're a reviver. You've revived something. So our mothers and wives, they're trim tabbers. They are the small rudder that turns the big rudder that turns the entire ship. The imams had mothers. And they were the means of them becoming leaders. Imam Malik, did you not take Imam Malik to his teacher and say, "Allimhu al-adab," teach him adab, قبل أن تعلمه العلم. Look at the advice of a mother. That's a leader. And she created a leader. Imam Dar al-Hijrah, Imam Malik, rahmatullahi alayh. Imam Abi Hanifa had a mother. Imam Ahmed had a mother. Imam al-Shafi'i had a mother. The giants upon whose shoulders we are trying to walk. We can't say we walk, we're trying to walk on their shoulders. These giants had mothers. La ilaha illallah. You see how important it is? They were the core and the epicenter behind them becoming leaders. And they were the ships that turned the world's direction. But you see how that ship needs a rudder? You don't see the rudder, but it's there. And how that rudder needs another rudder? It's there. It's there. So my dear mothers and sisters, you are trim tabbers. You are trim tabbers. Now, our mothers, walillah alhamdulillah, are natural leaders. They're natural leaders. As I said, I'm gonna try and speak about this in a way that makes our sisters smile, alhamdulillah. Because women are softer than males, but it can take a bit of a knock. Alright? Our mothers are natural leaders. Think about it. If we sit back now and think of our mothers, what do we think about? We think about, subhanallah, how they had vision. All the time, right? They would juggle 101 household chores. You wake up in the morning, it's getting the kids ready for school, getting the husband's breakfast ready, making sure his clothes are ironed, making sure the kids' uniform is there, making sure the right books for the right subjects are in the bag so you don't go to school and it's science and you've got a math book instead of a science book. Sah wa lala? Is this not true? They're juggling 101 things. But tomorrow, what they're doing today matches what they want to achieve tomorrow. And what they did tomorrow matched what they wanted to achieve the next day. They never got lost. Amazing visionaries. Amazing visionaries. That in doing 101 things, they never lost sight of the goal. They never lost sight of the goal. This is a visionary. This is the first quality of leadership. They say a leader must be a visionary. Must have a vision. Must know where they want to get to. This is our mothers. Our mothers, they, when we ponder over everything that they are and that they were, if they've passed away, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them graves which are gardens from the gardens of Jannah. And if they're alive, then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to preserve them in His obedience. And if you're not a mother yet, we ask Allah to make you a mother soon. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. So, we see that they had an amazing ability to exercise patience. This is another leadership quality. They would exercise patience in juggling all these activities, in dealing with the different natures of the child. One child is upset, one child is crying, one child is sulking, one child is happy. Dealing with all these personalities from morning till evening. And still meeting her husband with a smiley face. What amazing patience. And she wakes up the next day to do it again. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. It was not a case where khalas, it's done. Tomorrow, that's it. I've retired. They never would retire. They mothers right till the end. Subhanallah. Now, even if you're 50 years old or 60 years old, your mother still sees you as a child. If you came home and told your mother, for example, that look, today I got this, she'll say, yeah, look after it. You might be a 50-year-old man, but she'll say, look after it, because to her, you're still her child. So they have this amazing ability to be patient. This is a mother's role in the home, right? So what have we taught our sisters so far? They need to be visionaries. They need to be patient. But we're teaching it in a different way. We're discussing our mothers and how they were. This is the qualities of the female. We discussed what the qualities of the male should be in the home to exacerbate leadership in the home and the presence of it. These are our mothers. They are patient. Also our mothers, they had amazing abilities to make us self-sufficient. This is what a leader does. A leader never ever leads their team in such a way that they're only dependent on them. They always lead it in a way that they become leaders in and of themselves in the tasks that they do. This whole concept of taking ownership. Taking ownership. Our mothers taught us that. Did they not make us clean our rooms when we got to the age? They cleaned it for us when we couldn't pick up things. But as soon as we could, they taught us to pick it up. And if we didn't, there was a naughty corner. Right? So they taught us self-sufficiency. A mother should have this quality to teach the child to be self-sufficient. This is from the qualities of being a leader and from the qualities of making someone a leader. When you're a visionary, you make them a visionary. When you're patient, you give them the quality of patience. When you introduce in their lives the concept of self-sufficiency, they will take it to the next level when they traverse throughout their lives, but you've taught it to them. So our mothers had this amazing ability to teach us how to be self-sufficient. Our mothers inspired us. This is from the qualities of a leader. They were inspired, they taught us inspiration and the qualities of being an inspired individual. So they were leaders and they have nurtured us to become leaders. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them the highest paradises. Ameen. They taught us how to inspire others. We know this. We know this, that they would always teach us to take the higher ground. A father might say, you know what, if somebody's bullying you, bully him back. What would a mother say that? No, you should behave in this particular manner. You should behave in a different manner. You should try and diffuse the situation this way. They always taught us to be inspirational, how to inspire others. That don't tread the same path as the next person. If a person is treading the low path, don't follow the low path. Show them the high path. Don't go down to their level. Bring them up to your level. Not so. This is quality of the female in the home. Again, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them the highest paradises. So a leader should know how to inspire others. This is a mother.